So how do you set up your wheel and pedals in ACC? We're going to let you know here. We've got a rig with Moser equipment on it. Sam, our professional carter, is going to be helping us do this. So this is what you do. You go to options. By the way, we've had a big issue setting up this Moser equipment on ACC here in this new studio. We had to swap over some cables. Now it's working. So if you're watching and struggling with that, then hopefully that helps. So Sam, you, by the way, you've never used Moser equipment. First thoughts?
Never used Moser at all. Never played ACC.
Wow.
It's going to be interesting. So, baptism of fire.
But professional carter, you've carted a lot in different countries using different equipment. Your own car, also provided carts as well. So you know what sort of the ergonomics should be. So I'm going to click steering here. This is a moment of truth, Dan.
You ready?
Yeah. Is it on?
Yeah.
So pedals on. Let me just check the Moser. This is what we were struggling with before. So turn the wheel stand again. So the wheel's showing up for me in Moser pit house. So let's try buttons as well. Shift up. So shifting up not working. Why could that be? See, it says Moser base RS.
Five.
R5 here. We have a Moser R9. So again, I'm going to get rid of that. I'm going to get rid of the clutch because Matt might be confused. Do you want to try again? Oh!
Oh, we have steering. We have steering.
Yes! It's been 2 hours.
Yes.
It's been 2 hours. We're excited. So there we go. So I think top tip is that I actually had to quit out. I think the Moser R5 had the clutch. And I think that's because, and I'm going to get really nerdy here, so if you enjoy this, the way we've set this up is we've got the Moser R9 base going into the laptop. We have the Moser SRP pedals going into the laptop separately.
Yep.
What we had before was the Moser R5, and you see it said clutch there? That's because the Moser R5 comes with SRP light pedals.
Okay.
And it all has to be used together. So it probably, it was confused about the axes. It didn't think there could be another axis. So you've got steering there. Do you want to see what it's like on the old rotation? So
slow.
I've got you at 900 degrees here in my Moser pit house. I don't know what, if you have a preference on rotation, Sam?
I use 900 on iRacing.
Okay, so that, let's see if 900 feels right. Do you want to check your throttle pressure? There you go, throttle.
That's good.
Brake. We'll see how that is because we're on a GT Mega wheel stand here, so it's not, you know, like the GT Mega Prime.
You can't really lean into it.
Yeah, so we'll see if we need to calibrate that. I would just wonder here if there's a...
Should we try the paddles?
What? We can do a maximum limit here and bring it back. Do you want to try braking that? So that's going to be full pressure there, I think. Yeah. Sorry, what was that, Sam?
Should we try the paddles?
Yep, let's do shift up then. And shift down. Okay, we're now going to go into ACC and see how that's worked. You can see here we've also got force feedback. I've got another video on all the force feedback settings, a 400 hertz frequency gain. I can let you know, Sam, that you're running on 100% on the R9 in terms of force feedback.
Oh, right. So it's going to snap my arms.
Because you're normally using G29, are you using? No, or Thrustmaster?
Fanatec V25.
Fanatec CS.
Yeah, CSL V2.5,
the Clubsport one. Okay, so let's see how this is going to work. So I'm going to go back here, back, and we're going to start the race at Brands Hatch.
Going double file.
You're going to be in this bumper view here. So it looks like the shifters are working. Is the steering working?
Yeah, it's all working.
Yeah, although, to me, it looks like you might struggle through Druids.
I don't think I'll get enough lock.
Yeah. So let's see how this is going to work then. I am very excited for this. So you can see, by the way, the inputs on the bottom right of the screen there. So you can see the throttle with the traction control and the brake as well. We didn't set a minimum, so we didn't set a dead zone. Sam's using his karting boots and his real world karting gloves, by the way. And first time on ACC, so no pressure or anything.
Yeah.
But we're just interested to see. Sam, why don't you talk us through the force feedback and the inputs and how it's sort of feeling?
So the force feedback is extremely strong compared to what I'm used to. The actual wheel feels really nice to use. I can get round the corner just.
Do you think this force, because this is quite a narrow direct. Oh, God. Oh, whoa. Almost saved it.
Almost.
Let's rejoin and we can just cruise. Because this wheel is quite a narrow diameter. to say a circular wheel or even your Fantech BMW wheel.
Yeah.
So I think it makes it harder anyway. If you want, I can press a button and reduce the intensity to 50% and we see how that feels.
I mean, yeah, if we can do that, because I am flexing the stand a little bit.
So what I'm going to do is put that to 50. That should now immediately feel lighter.
A lot lighter, almost too light now.
Okay, well, why don't we do increments? I'll do 80%.
That's better. That feels a lot better straight away.
Yeah. My personal feeling is when I drove a GT3 as well, is that it's power steering. It's not like karting.
It doesn't need to be.
Yeah. You don't want to be fighting it. I feel like you might be still fighting it a little bit. Should I turn it down a little bit more? Or
you can go down a little bit, but don't go massive.
It's at 70, so maybe that's going to be a sweet spot.
Oh, I don't have a lot, though.
Yeah. Should we try and fix a lot then actually?
Let me just try this corner here. Maybe I just understeered off.
I feel like the lock is... Because I can see your dot, actually, on ACC, that it's right in the corner. We'll see when you come around here. See, I feel that feels understeery.
Safe, though, somehow.
Yeah.
Not quite sure how...
We haven't done any tyre pressures or anything, so...
It's literally just standard setup.
Let me see when you go through Druids, because that should be sort of a max lock. Oh my goodness, on the limit. So here we go, I'm looking at the dot.
My arms, I'm
actually... Yeah. So Sam, I'm just going to pause the game, that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Oh, I pressed something else that was not pause. So I just want to explain to our viewers that there's two ways of dealing with lock. We've got the Moser Pit House software, like any software like Fanatec, Moser, all of them, you can set your lock there with a direct drive wheel. Because unlike a belt-driven wheel, it actually has basically unlimited lock when you think about it.
Yeah, so my Fanatec, I can turn, and that's it.
Yeah.
It's done. Whereas this
will just go forever.
Just spin it continuously.
Interesting, the Logitech G Pro has a hard lock, even though it's direct drive wheel. So we're going to go to controls here, and we see your steering. So if you just turn your steering wheel, Sam, so you can see here.
That's 90 degrees.
So again... There's a scale there, and there's a steering lock 900. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to... might sound aggressive. I'm going to go to 540
okay.
in the gate, in Moser Pit House. So if you turn it again...
90 degrees.
And turn it a bit more like you were doing sort of full lock. Okay.
That's it.
Now keep that there. I'm going to put this down to 540. So if you try that and turn now. In fact, let's redo that. So just turn it now again. Is that a bit more than we had before, do you think? Or
Possibly a little bit more. So I think we can...
What they say in ACC, and this is the old advice, is that you should actually put this at 1080 and then the wheel sort of sorts itself out. Oh, goodness, it goes up now.
12.
Yeah. It's not fantastically intuitive. So I'm going to match that here. You've got 1080 in both. So let's just try again.
That's worse.
That's worse. Okay.
Way worse.
So let's do our 540 then. 540 there. 540 here. Give us a...
Yeah. Better.
We'll just do it again to keep it in the middle. Just...
In the middle?
Yep. And do it again so it's picked up. Are you happy with your midpoint there? Does that feel in the middle when you put in the middle? Was it?
That would be middle there, so yes. That's
okay.
About right.
Right. We'll restart the race. We're not sim racing, like, we weren't born with sim racing. We've come into it. So if some of these things seem basic, then apologies, but that's like.
It's learning as we go.
We're just learning as we go. So hopefully it's helpful.
All right, it already feels more responsive.
Yeah. So, in ACC, the tyre pressures are very critical.
Are they?
And see that tyre's there. You have your inner, your middle, your outer.
Yeah.
And basically, you want to get them up to a certain PSI. I forget what the meta PSI is now. But you, when you're karting, you must, on the warm-up laps...
Yeah, so on the warm-up laps, it depends on the weather. If it's a real cold day, you want to heat up the tyres as best you can. Sometimes, though, it's actually better to warm up the engine.
Yeah.
So say you're going PFI, for example, which is a long straight, you'd warm up the engine more than the tyres. Clear on the left. Car on the left.
Clear on the left. Well, I have to say, I don't want to jinx it, but you already look really confident. Considering this is your first time in ACC and the most... Oh, Lambo on the outside.
We're good.
Side by side, I think. You see the radar where it's in a bit more of a natural position? It's your first time using this radar.
First time playing the game, using the wheels, the whole baptism.
Oh, wow. Using all the track. I would have been
Bobby.
We paid for it. We're going to use it.
Look, when I play golf.
How's the... exactly, in the rough. How's the force feedback?
It's good. Car on the left. Bit of oversteer.
And I'm just looking at your inputs on the pedals. That little tweak. Oh, yeah, because that little tweak, though, to the max on the pedals, I think is really hard. Because if we didn't have that, I think you'd be struggling to stop it just because this rig system doesn't quite have the...
Yeah, it's not... It's a bit of flex, isn't it, to say the least.
But there we go. That's how you set up the inputs in Assetto Corsa Competizione on PC. It is similar on console, actually. Let us know if you've got any questions and we'll try and answer them because we've got this amazing setup here. And yeah, we'll see you next time.